We are here in one of the laboratories of the TU Delft. The name of this building is Daydream Hall. This acronym stands for Delft Dream Realization of Extremely Advanced Machines. And it is the place where our student dream teams work on innovative vehicles, rockets, medical microbiology, robotics and eco-engineering design projects. We are speaking with Wim Thijs, the director of this Daydream Hall. Hi Wim, could you explain to us the vision and mission of this Daydream Hall?
I think for short, what we do here is learning by doing. The students want to use their hands, also their brains, but also their hands. They want to build things, and they can build things here. And inside the curriculum, there's not so much anymore to be built. But here they can do it, and they do that in area of all kind of competitions. And they are really challenged by that, building solar cars, very fuel efficient cars, rockets, etc., etc. So they become better engineers by learning by doing, and they learn it themselves.
A great many of these innovations focus on energy-related innovations, particularly in the interface transport energy. Could you show us some examples?
Yes, I can. Just follow. So we are here with the so-called Eco Runner team. And this is our Eco Runner. And what is the Eco Runner? A very fuel efficient car, little car, just built for a person of at least 50 kilos. 50 kilos, that is required by the rules. So we found a girl which weighs only 50 kilos, this big, this small. She fits in, and she moved on the energy equivalent of 1 liter normal gasoline. Nearly 3,000 kilometers, and actually she doesn't drive on real gasoline but on hydrogen. And we have in the back of the girl, there's a little machine in here, and that machine is this one. This is a fuel cell, and what goes in is a little bit of hydrogen and also oxygen. What comes out, very little bit of water, pure water, some worms, and major point, electricity. And then in the rear wheel, there's one wheel only in the back. Inside the wheel, there's a little electric engine, and that is propelling this machine, this fuel efficient. And why is it that fuel efficient? Because it's light, it is small, and you can see here the model in which this is a model of this shape. Okay. Is put in a wind tunnel, and that's how the students figure out how to get the least resistance from the air. So then you can move, well, hopefully in the near future, not only 3,000 kilometers, but the aim is to go over 5,000 kilometers by just 1 liter of gasoline.
Suppose this will be a breakthrough technology. Do you think it will have impact on the infrastructures?
Well, it for sure will, because you need hydrogen on the way, because you cannot take an infinite amount of hydrogen with you in your car. So you have to make not gasoline station, but hydrogen stations. So that will have huge impact. But that is one of the reasons why nobody knows these days who will be the winner. So we do have this team is aiming for a fuel efficient car on hydrogen. We have another team which wants to go very, very fast on hydrogen. So they want to spread, they believe in the gospel of hydrogen, but we have other believers also, other teams. One team is building a very fast motorcycle running on bioethanol, which is also an option for the future. We have the normal battery cars, a very, very fast car, the fastest accelerating car in the world has been built here. And we have, of course, the solar. But whoever is the winner in the future, it will have a huge impact on the infrastructure, that's for sure. And who will be the winner of those? I don't know.